Hello children, welcome to class 4 social studies. Chapter 1, the story of the past and evidences in history. We have already learned this lesson chapter and discussed everything that the exercise and short answers. I hope all of you have done all this in copy. Okay. Today we will discuss the long answer type questions. Question number 1. What are inscriptions? How do they help us to know about ancient India? Take out your page number 12, long answer type questions. What are inscriptions? How do they help us to know about ancient India? Okay. So, two part. This question has two parts. What are inscriptions? First, you have to write the definition. Then second, how do they help us to know about the ancient India? Inscriptions, all of you know, inscriptions you have learned in this chapter. What is inscription? Inscriptions are written records which were carved on rocks, cave walls, metal pillars, walls of temples and on clay. And the large number of inscriptions belonging to the Emperor Ashoka of Maurya dynasty has also been found. That also we have learned. Mainly these inscriptions of ancient India were made by the kings and royal patrons of that period. Kings and royal families members made this. So it is also an important source of important archaeological source. So when we write the answer, what are inscriptions? How do they help us to know about ancient India? The answer is, inscriptions are written records which were carved on rocks, cave walls, metal pillars, walls of temples and on clay. Then they help us to know about the kings, royal patrons and life of common people of ancient India. Clear all of you? They help us to know about the kings, royal patrons and life of common people of ancient India. Okay. Not only the kings and royal patrons, but also the life of the common people of ancient India. In this way, it helps us to know about ancient India. Clear all of you? Yes. Then second question. How coins help us to know about any archaeological source? How coins help us to know about any archaeological source? Coins, you know, coins are also valuable source of information because the history of coins starts from the ancient India to the present. And the coins also contain the figures of kings and gods. Some contain names and the dates of the rulers, okay, who built it. Then coins also throw significant light on economic life of ancient people. They indicate regarding trade and commerce and help to reconstruct the history of several ruling dynasties. Clear? These are all the things, informations provided provided coins. Okay. So coins are very important, valuable source of information. Okay. So when you write the answer, you have to write like this. Coins are valuable source of information. These tell us about the economy and finance of the kingdom. It also tells about the extent of a king's empire and the trade with other regions. Clear all of you? How coins help us to know about any archaeological source? Coins are valuable source of information. These tell us about the economy and finance of the kingdom. It also tells about the extent of a king's empire and the trade with other regions. Clear? Yes. So these two question answer we have discussed today. So these two long answer you have to do in copy. Okay. Before doing this long answer in copy, you have to draw some pictures in copy. Some archaeological source, for example, monuments picture, page number in your page It is given there, the homework is given there. Page number 12, things to do. Paste pictures of historical monuments. Any 2-3 pictures of historical monuments. Indian monuments you write, okay. You draw. Okay, draw or paste. Paste some pictures. Indian historical monuments. Then artifacts picture. Artifacts, you know, the things made by the people in the past. Example, pottery, tools, metal objects, jewelry, ornaments, weapons. You can draw, or if you get picture, that picture also you can paste. Okay, then coins. So artifacts, 2-3 artifacts picture, coins, then 2-3 monuments picture, you have to draw in copy. Then do the long answer. Clear? Okay, bye.